What is up, guys? It is RSC6414 here, back with another video. This time I'm reviewing TNA One Night Only Pay-Per-View Old School. This event took place in the Civic Center in Poughkeepsie, New York. Overall, good show, one of the best TNA One Night Only shows. I was started a video on this particular review. 15 minutes into it, I had technical difficulties, so I'm starting over. This probably will not be as long as that. But I will still give you a review and who won each match. First match of the night, we had Chris Sabin versus Austin Aries versus Sanjay Dutt. This match was good, back and forth action. At one point, Chris Sabin hit a tornado DDT on Sanjay Dutt. Austin Aries would end up hitting the Brain Buster on Sanjay Dutt for the 1-2-3. Austin Aries would pick up the win over Sanjay Dutt and Chris Sabin in a triple threat match. And overall, pretty good match. I enjoyed it. Good way to open up the show. And yeah, that's about it. The next match we had was EC3, Ethan Carter III versus Dewey Barnes. Ethan Carter would end up hitting the one percenter, aka the headlock driver, in like a 3-minute match, squash match over Dewey Barnes. What you'd expect here, EC3, Ethan Carter III picks up the win over Dewey Barnes. In kind of a whatever 2 or 3 minute match, probably one of the worst matches in the show, to be honest. You knew who was going to win. EC3 picks up the win. Next match, we had Bully Ray versus Tommy Dreamer. ECW, ECW, ECW. Brought back memories here. You heard some ECW chants throughout the match. This match was a falls count anywhere match. Basically, that means you can pin them anywhere you want. This was a good match. I really enjoyed it. Kind of old friends in a match squaring off one-on-one. Just good stuff. At one point, Tommy Dreamer hit the Dreamer Driver on Bully Ray through a table. That was a near fall. At another point, Bully Ray got the oil out. He put it all over a table that was in the ring. He was about to get the flame, but Tommy Dreamer took out Bully Ray. Tommy Dreamer was about to light the table on fire when Bully Ray low blows Tommy Dreamer from behind. Bully Ray would hit the Bully Cutter on Tommy Dreamer for the 1-2-3. Bully Ray would pick up the win here over Tommy Dreamer in a good match, one of the better matches of the night. I was expecting a lot going in this match, and it did not disappoint it whatsoever. A good match. I really enjoyed this match. Bully Ray picks up the win as you'd expect on a TNA show, but overall, good stuff from both guys. Next match we had was a 3-on-3 mixed tag action. You had Bad Influence and Velvet Sky versus the Bromance and Lady Tapa. Bad Influence said that Velvet Sky was their favorite knockout, which is why they got paired up as a tag team since they were in the ring. Eric Young said he was president of the night, whatever that means. just some typical Eric Young shenanigans, but Eric Young would be the special guest referee of the night for this match. 3-on-3 tag action, like I said, Bad Influence and Velvet Sky versus the Bromans, Jesse Goddard and Robbie E, and Lady Tapa. This match was pretty good. It surprised me. I wasn't expecting too much going into this match, but it was good. It was back and forth. One point, Velvet Sky hit a crossbody on Lady Tapa. At another point, Bad Influence picked Velvet Sky up. They tossed her out of the ring, and she hit a crossbody on Lady Tapa outside of the ring. And then right at the very end, Bad Influence hit the high low on Jesse Goddard for the 1-2-3. Kazarian would pick up the win here when Bad Influence hit the high low on Jesse Goddard for the winning pinfall. Kazarian would pin Jesse Goddard for the win. So, therefore, Bad Influence and Velvet Sky defeated the Bromans and Lady Tapa, which I thought would probably be the case. But good match. Definitely didn't expect a lot from it, but it turned out to be pretty good. The next match we had was Jeff Hardy versus Abyss in a Monsters Ball match. Good stuff from both guys here. Two TNA greats going at it in the ring at Abyss's match. This was really good. One of the best matches of the night, in my opinion. At one point, there was a table set up ringside outside of the ring. Jeff Hardy was on the top rope. Abyss threw a steel chair. It hit Jeff Hardy right in the head when he was on the top rope. He falls off the top rope, goes right through the table on the outside. That was a pretty good spot there. At another point, you had a Abyss choke slam Jeff Hardy. There's some pile of thumbtacks in the ring. Abyss choke slam Jeff Hardy. Jeff Hardy landed right on the thumbtacks. That was a pretty cool spot. Jeff Hardy would be busted open after that. Then in another part of the match, you had Jeff Hardy. There was a barbed wire, a little table platform Abyss got thrown on. Then Jeff Hardy put another barbed wire table on Abyss. Jeff Hardy would get on the top rope, Swanton bomb, and would sandwich Abyss right through those barbed wire tables. He'd pin Abyss for the 1, 2, 3, and Jeff Hardy would pick up the win over Abyss with the Swanton bomb right on the two barbed wire tables and would sandwich Abyss between both of them, picking up the win. I thought this was one of the best matches of the night, along with Bully Ray and Tommy Dreamer. Good stuff from both guys. Jeff Hardy picks up the win over Abyss via pin with the Swanton bomb. Next match we had Kurt Angle versus Mr. Anderson. I was expecting a little more going into this match. It was not as good as I was hoping, but it wasn't like very bad either. At one point, Kurt Angle had the ankle lock in. Mr. Anderson countered. He hit the mic check on Kurt Angle for a near fall. Towards the end of the match, Kurt Angle was up in the corner on the ropes. Mr. Anderson ran at Kurt Angle. Angle moved out of the way. Anderson hit the turnbuckle pad. Kurt Angle hit the angle slam on on Anderson for the 1, 2, 3. Kurt Angle would pick up the win here over Mr. Anderson with the angle slam. So Kurt Angle picks up the win here. I was expecting Angle to win here. Nothing special, but wasn't too bad. I was expecting a little more, like I said, but I wasn't too disappointed either. So, decent match. The next match we had was Bobby Roode versus James Storm in a last man standing match. This match was, I thought, another great match here. One of three pretty good matches of Bully Ray, Tommy Dreamer, Jeff Hardy, and Abyss, and Bobby Roode and James Storm, I thought, were the three best matches of the night on the show. This match, back and forth, there was various weapons used. You had trash cans, steel chairs, the little steel barricades that they have, that was used as well. Tables, good stuff. At one point, you had Bobby Roode hit the Death Valley Driver on James Storm right through a table. James Storm would get up at the count of 9, right before the 10 count. Bobby Roode would handcuff James Storm towards the end of the match. He'd have James Storm handcuffed behind his back like this, so James Storm couldn't pick himself up with his hands. So towards the last 5 minutes, James Storm would probably get up around 8 or 9 with his handcuffs on him. And then right towards the end of the match, vintage Bobby Roode, vintage beer money Bobby Roode, grabbed the beer bottle from under the ring. If you remember in 2012 when James Storm and Bobby Roode were feuding, Bobby Roode would pick up a lot of wins with that beer bottle smashing over James Storm's head. Bobby Roode would slam the beer bottle across James Storm's head, right across the face. The beer bottle would shatter. James Storm falls to the ground. Earl Hebner gets to the 10 count. James Storm doesn't get up, and Bobby Roode picks up the win here over James Storm by shattering the beer bottle over James Storm's head. James Storm doesn't get up before the 10 count. Therefore, Bobby Roode picks up the win. And yeah, so then we have our final match of the night. A good match between Bobby Roode and James Storm, like I said, though. And now we have our final match of the night, Samoa Joe versus Magnus, TNA World Heavyweight Championship match. Magnus being the TNA World Heavyweight Champion, obviously. We all knew Magnus would not lose this title since this show is filmed on December 30th. And he's held the title. He had the title, obviously, on last night's episode of Impact. So how would he lose it December 30th? This match was good, even though you knew Magnus was gonna retain. It wasn't that good, to be honest. It was whatever, kind of like the Kurt Angle Anderson match. You were expecting a little more, but you didn't get that much. But it wasn't too disappointing. It was just kind of decent wrestling. This match was back and forth. There were some screwy finishes, obviously, what you'd expect with this Magnus Dixie Carter kind of authority angle like WWE has. This match, back and forth, you'd have Samoa Joe accidentally Magnus was going for a move. He'd kind of like twist Samojo around. Samojo's foot would hit Earl Hebner and take Earl Hebner out of like referee action for like 3 minutes. So then at one point you had Samojo hit an enziguri, and then he'd hit the jawbreaker on Magnus. He'd pin him. There's like a six count, and then all of a sudden Brian Hebner comes in the ring. One, two, EC3 comes from behind, pulls Brian Hebner out of the ring, so he can't finish the pinfall. Samojo takes Ethan Carter III out with a suicide dive. He gets back in the ring. Magnus has the TNA World Heavyweight Championship. He turns around and nails Samojo across the face with the TNA World Heavyweight Championship. Right after he does that, he throws the championship out of the ring. Earl Hebner regains consciousness magically and then pins one, two, three. Magnus picks up the win here over Samoa Joe with the screwy finish when Magnus hits Samoa Joe with the TNA World Heavyweight Championship. Hebner didn't see it, obviously. Magnus picks up the win, retains the TNA World Heavyweight Championship in a screwy, screw job fashion, which you'd expect here. Overall, this show was good. TNA One Night Only Old School pay-per-view. I thought this was the best One Night Only pay-per-view they've had of the One Night Only pay-per-view series that they've come out with. This event, in my opinion, was the best one. Good match, good stuff. The overall grade I'd give this show, 7.5 out of 10. 7.5 out of 10 is the overall grade I'd give this pay-per-view show. I definitely recommend checking this show out. I definitely will buy this show on DVD when they release it on Shop TNA. Overall, good stuff, good show. I hope you enjoyed this video. Check out my other videos and subscribe. Thanks, guys.